Everybody who knows me well knows that I'm bananas about bananas. So being on La Palma is a bit like being Charlie in the chocolate factory for me. The island is covered in banana plantations, and about 40% of the farmable ground is used for banana plants. If you heard me say banana plant just yet, you heard me right. Because even though it looks like a tree and it's really tall, actually it's more similar to a leek.
I always thought that bananas grew on trees instead of plants. But it turns out there's a lot more to know about bananas than you would think. So we're going to learn a lot more about them and maybe even help out on a banana plantation, but more on that later. And let's take a small detour through the bananas right here. But man, the bananas here are so much better.
Yeah, the bananas are so much sweeter over here.
And apparently they're a totally different race from the ones that we get in the Netherlands. Oh man, look at how many plants they are growing just in this area.
At the moment we're purposely riding to a banana field. But I noticed that a lot of the times on La Palma, you set up your navigation and then you end up on a road in the middle of banana plantations. With a lot of small roads and views like this. It's fantastic.
So the other day we went to a banana museum, which was actually a lot more interesting than the name makes it sound.
Yeah.
But they had set up a complete showcase of the history and growth of bananas on La Palma. But the cool thing was that you get a guided tour on which the guide explains in more detail how things go on a real farm. So it was really interesting to learn more about how bananas grow, especially since about 40% of the gross domestic product of La Palma is due to the banana industry.
The banana grows like a leek and it produces a flower which grows from the middle that produces the bananas. A banana plant only produces banana once and after that it dies off. And during all the time there will be small offspring around the banana plant and they have to be killed off like the tour guide told us. So only one remains.
A lot of children around, thousands, and you have to kill them.
Yeah, and the banana bunch can grow to weigh around 70 kilograms, so the plant needs to be reinforced with iron bars so the trunk doesn't break. So you also see a lot of individual plants and plantations like this that are covered up to protect the bunches from wind and insects. And the bananas get damaged quite easily, so they get harvested when they are still green, since their skin is a bit stronger then.
Also, the guide told us that apart from the fruit, the plant can be used for a lot of other stuff.
Yeah.
What we can do with the flowers, we can make tea, we can make chips, we can eat in salad, always cooking before.
So we're gonna visit an organic farmer named Fran, who can tell us much more about his work, and also we're gonna check out if we can help him out a bit on the farm, since his plantation got destroyed after the volcanic eruption last year. There will also be another group of volunteers from Tenerife helping out rebuilding his farm, so yeah, let's check it out.
Because there are a big festival in Tenerife, another BioFest festival, about this all this concept. And one of the actions is came to La Palma to learn and to help the people who live here. I mean, today is the action. And they helped us to plant 100 banana little plants. And then there are people who work with bees, agricultors, technical people, people who work with animals and other things in the forest, and the things that we need around to be self-sufficient.
My name is Fran Garlat. I worked in the past in recreation of ecosystems and build ecosystems indoor and other beautiful things, butterfly houses or something like these, big aquariums. And one day, why don't put in production, like in natural, our agricultural systems? The philosophy of this plantation, of this kind of agriculture, is really recreation of ecosystems. Work like in the nature, the really laboratory. then a lot of biodiversity, a lot of different kinds of plants. Not all of them are useful for the humans. A lot of them we can't put in the market, but it's necessary to grow so safely, so without any kind of problems. We haven't got problems that much with insects. There are all the insects that can live around. All the plants are living here, but in colored levels, no? Then we need this kind of balance. So we produce principally we produce bananas, but we produce mango, avocado, papaya, sugarcane, a lot of different kinds of tropical and subtropical plants. We have animals too, to help to close the shelter. We think in the self-sufficient. In one moment now in the planet that it's necessary that the communities can produce the food that they need day per day, because we need bread, drink and eat all the days, the three first necessities. And now we import, in Europe, we import the 80, the 90% of the food that we eat. We are the slaves. Then the bioagriculture, this is more than bio, this is work with ecosystems, edible forest, okay? Is the, I think, the way they produce so nutritive food in an easy way, and year by year, these grounds, this soil, this plantation produce more and more with less. It's fantastic. Let's go to work.
Man, I'm a bit speechless.
Yeah. Sometimes you just meet someone and instantly feel if they are genuine. And I work in sales, so I meet a lot of different people every day. And many of them just put on an act for their own gain. And it's really refreshing to talk to someone like Fran that is so passionate about helping out the planet and inspiring other people to do better.
Yeah, totally. Yeah. Yeah, and it was interesting to hear his message about people needing to get more self-sustainable.
Yeah.
So everybody gets more independent when something happens in the world. And I think it's really cool that in a few years our banana plants will produce bananas.
Yeah, maybe I'll get to eat one someday.
Yeah.
So, we've learned a lot about the banana. It was an eye-opener to see how important the banana is to La Palma. Also, it was really interesting to chat with Fran about his eco farm. And if you want to know more, check the description. Also, in our last video, we chatted with Fran about his farm and why his harvest was ruined by the volcano.